today for grade 6 we are going to see about computer science. So from this class we are going to discuss about MS Excel 2010. MS Excel 2010. So 2010 is the version and we are going to see about MS Excel. What are the uses of MS Excel? So we can able to perform calculations, we can create spreadsheets and enter the data in the MS Excel. So in this chapter we are going to learn about several formatting features. So we are going to learn formatting features. So that are used in the MS Excel 2010. So first one is the formatting numbers. First one is the formatting numbers. So the numbers entered in MS Excel 2010 would be value, data, time. So MS Excel can accept a value, data, time. So we can choose the format of the digit by following the step. First we have to select the range of cells that we want to format. Suppose if we want to enter the data from cell 1 to cell 20, first we have to select the cells. So click on the home tab, number group, we have to select the number format. From home tab we have to select the number group from the number format. So next, we have to select the desired format from the drop-down list. So a list of formatting options will appear. We have to select the desired format from the drop-down list. And finally, we have to click on the OK button. So otherwise, we can also follow home tab, sales group. The format drop-down list will appear. From that, we have to select format cells option. So format cells dialog box will open. From that, we have to select the number tab. So the select desired style from the category. Then we can able to select the desired number format. Then finally we have to click on the OK button. So another one option is also there. So first we have to right click the mouse and select the format cells. So by clicking on the cells, we have to click on the right click and the format cells option. From that format dialog box will open. So from that we can able to select the number tab. So desired category will be chosen and we have to click the button. So the data in the selected range of cells would appear in the selected format. So if I want to give the numbers, I can give the numbers. If I want to give letters, I can give the letters. So these are the number format options in MS Excel. Next we are moving to modifying data. So the data entered in the MS Excel worksheet can be modified. If I want to name the cell, if I want to change the data in the MS Excel, that is the modification. We can do it in the MS Excel 2010. So to change the data already in this cell, we have to follow some steps. First one, click on the cell having the data that needs to be changed. Suppose the cell is in A1. Have you all heard about MS Excel cells, row, column? So row is nothing but it is the horizontal boxes. Column, vertical boxes. Columns will be from A to Z. If the Z is, it starts from AA, AB, etc. So rows starts from 1,48,576 rows are there in MS Excel. Cell means combination of row and column. So click on the cell having the data that need to be changed. If I want to change the cell A1, that is column is A, first row. So I have to select the cell. So click on to select the cell. The entire data of the cells has to be changed. If I want to change the data in the cell, I have to select the particular cell. So double click the cell, a part of the data needs to be changed. So if I want to change only a particular part, I can select that particular part in the cell. Suppose I have written name as NAAME. I have to delete one A. So I can able to select the letter A and I can able to click the delete button. So you can also press F12 key to edit the cell contents. What is the F12? So it is a function key. We can also use this function key to edit the data in the MS Excel. So next we are moving to. So replace it with the new data and press enter key on the keyboard. So if I have deleted the letter A, I can press the enter key. So it will be correct format. NAME. This is the correct format of name. Next one, we are moving to formatting data. Modifying means already existing existing data will be changed. Formatting. So we have already learned in the earlier classes how to format in MS Excel. So we can also learn how to change the font, format border, apply pattern and color to the cell. Let us learn how to give the color and pattern to the cell. Cell means intersection of row and column. Formatting the font. Font means we have different type of font. For example, Arial, Calibri, Body, then Times New Roman. These are the different type of font. Let us see how to change the format in the MS Excel. So we have to follow these steps to change the font in MS Excel. So select this cell of a range of cells. So if I want to change for only one cell, I have to select only one cell. If I want to select range of cells, what is the meaning of range of cells? Range of cells is nothing but if I want to change changes from cell number 20 to 25, I have to select that 20 to 25. It is called range of cells. So we have to right click on the mouse and select the format cells option. So I have to right click this cell and select the format cells option. So the format cell dialog box will appear. So click the font tab in the dialog box. So this is the dialog box. So in this dialog box we have to click on the font tab. There is a tab named font links to the alignment. You have to select that tab. So you may select the required format of font. For example, font size, font style, color, etc. Suppose I want a color as red, pink or blue, I can able to select using this font dialog box. So I can able to use size. So what is the font size, color and style? They are nothing but our letters will appear differently. So then this is called as the font. So finally, if I have made all the changes, I have to click on the OK button. So the changes will be applied for the cell. So otherwise we can also able to select the cell of range of cells. Click on the home tab. Home tab is next to file tab. So home tab, font group, we can able to change the font size, color or font style. Next one we are going to bond formatting. So we know how to change the font of the cell, font of the letter or any number. Next we are going to bond formatting. So how to change the border for a cell? So first we have to select the cell which we have to apply the border. So right click on the mouse and select the format cells. So we have to click on the format cells option. So by clicking on the format cells option, shortcut. So the format cells dialog box will appear. This is the format cells dialog box. So using this dialog box, we can able to select the border tab. We should not select font tab. We should select border tab. Why we are selecting border tab? Because we are going to change the border type. So we have to select the border tab. So by clicking on that, we have to select the style of lines. For example, what are the styles of border? Dot, 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 dash, dash, then flowers, then double line, broad line, short line. So there are different borders. So we have to select the style in the line section. We can also choose the different color. So if my box wants to, if my cell wants to appear in pink color, I can choose the pink color. Then select the borders from presets and border section. So we have to select presets and border section. Then finally, if I select that, we have to click on the OK button. So the borders will be applied to the cells. Next, we are going to formatting cells. So let us see what are the formatting options that are present in cells. So we can also change the pattern and background color of the cell. Yes, we can give background for our cells. Let us see how to give this. Select the cell or range of cells. Cell means single cell. Range of cell means from any particular range, for 1 to 5, 5 to 10, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, whatever it is. So this is the range of cells. So right click the mouse and select the format cells option. So we have to right click on the cell or range of cells and you have to select format cell option. So the format cell dialog box will appear. So format cell dialog box will appear. So we have to click on the fill tab. We have to click on the fill tab. So we can able to select the pattern and background color for the cell. We can also select pattern color, pattern style and background color. So finally we have to click on the OK button. So the changes will be applied for our cell. Next we are moving to data. So that is known as custom list. So to create the custom list, we have to follow some steps. Let us see what are the steps. First one, click on the file menu, then click the options. File menu, click the option, the Excel option dialog box will appear. So file menu, we have to click on the options. So Excel option dialog box will appear. Using the block, select the advanced tab. We have to select on the advanced tab. So this is the edit custom list option. We have to select the advanced tab. So using the edit custom list, the custom list dialog box appear. If I click on the edit custom list, custom list dialog box will appear. So enter the desired list under the list entry section. Click on the add button and then click OK. So there are some list of custom list. We can able to select the desired custom list. Finally, we have to click on the OK button. So we can also import the data by clicking on the import button. If I want to import the data already present in my system, I can also import it to do the Excel. Finally, I have to click on the OK button. Use the create a list with the fill handle. So we can create the list using the fill handle option. Next, we are moving to for present function. So what are for present functions? Why we use for present in MS Excel? Because it is a worksheet workbook. So if we want to do mathematical calculations, for example, if we want to add a set of cells, range of cells, so we can use formulas. So adding each and every cell will take number of time, but if we are using formula, we can easily able to calculate. For this purpose, we are using MS Excel. So the unique feature of unique means this is the most one important feature is spreadsheet program is that we can able to create mathematical formulas and execute functions. So if any number used in the formula changes, the entire spreadsheet is automatically updated. Suppose I have already entered number 10 in cell number 5. Next I am entering A5. Next I change it to 10. So the total value will automatically changes. This is the advanced feature of MS Excel. So here we can able to learn, add, divide, multiply and subtract the different using different formulas. Let us see how to use these formulas. So formula is generally made up of operand and operator. What is an operand and what are the operators? Operand means values, numbers are called as operand. Operator means plus symbol, minus symbol, multiplication, division symbol are called as operators. So the MS Excel 2010 formula can be set of values, cell reference, function, give without an operator. So if we want to add any two numbers, we have to select the cells. For example, I am going to add the cell value B3 and C4. So I have to select the cell range and finally I have to do the equal to sign. So after the formula has been typed in the cell, so the formula bar will appear. So we using the formula bar, we can able to perform the calculation. So we can also either enter the formula directly in the formula bar or double click the cell. If I am double clicking the cell, the formula gets entered and automatically calculates the value. So drag on the autofill option. So where is the autofill option to do the calculation automatically for the values? So it is in the formula bar. So we can click on the autofill option. So here we can able to see insertion function. Why we are using function? To perform mathematical operations. So formula for addition. So I am going to add here E2 to E5. So this is the formula copied using autofill. Here you can able to see drop down option. So by clicking on that, it automatically adds all these values. So for this is the formula bar. Here we can able to enter the formula. For example, using colon equal to sum of. Here, what is the cell? It is E2 to E2 colon E5. We can able to get the value. Next, we are going to special case. So we can we may even add the text using text formula. Yes, we can also add text. Not only numbers, we can also able to add text in MS Excel. A special case are given below. So first one, to add two strings of text values. how to write it in double quotes. Double quotes open, good, double quotes close, ampersand symbol, and I have to open, double quotes open, morning, double quotes close. Here they have given example, click and start. So we can able to get click start by pressing the enter button. So we can use the autofill option to fill the rest of the cells. We can also able to get autofill option to fill the rest of the. What is the use of autofill option? It automatically fills the cells. Next one, case two. To get the result along with the text, see the following example. So here we are going to enter the formula. So roll number ampersand B2 ampersand is ampersand A2. So I have roll number 21 is John. So I have selected a set of roll number with their name. So type in the desired location to display the result. So if I want to display the result in C2 or A2, I have to write the cell name here. So I using this formula bar, I am entering the formula. Then automatically it gets displayed in the selected cell. This, so once again I repeat, for example, I am selecting this C, that is C column. I want to display all these results in cell number D2. I have to select the cell number B2. If I am giving the formula, so it automatically gets entered in the D2. So next one, there are some error results also. Let us see what are the error results. Sometimes errors are displayed in the working cells or the formula bar in the place of results. A list of common errors. So what are the common errors? Let us learn. First one, ##. The column is not wide enough to display the result or the value. So if I am writing my name is, so it is a big length of sentence. So the error message will be displayed as ##. Means there is no space to enter this much of data. Next one, #div. It is division by zero error, invalid operation. So we cannot divide by zero. Next one, end by a. Data unavailable. So the data is not available. Next one, #value. Invalid data. The value is not enough. So it is invalid. It is not present. Next one, name. When the text is not recognized, so the text will not accept the data. If it is not accepting the data, the error message will be #name exclamatory mark. Next one, #reference may be invalid cell reference. So reference means it is invalid, it is not available. Then null ranges do not intersect, or the user is using an invalid range operator. If we use invalid operator, it will display #null exclamatory mark. These are some errors displayed in MS Excel. Next we are moving to some basic functions. So there are some basic functions used as formulas. So we can able to sum up this using basic function. So what are the basic function? Sum, maximum, minimum, count, average. So sum means total value, maximum means highest value, minimum means smallest value, count of. So how many count are there? Average means if I am having 5 values, I have to divide it by 5. It is the average. So let us see, first one is the sum. So it adds up all the values in the range. So how I can able to add, we use sum. So equal to sum of A1 to A10. I am adding A1 to A10. So finally it gets displayed. Equal to sum of G1 comma F6. So it finds the sum of the two cells. So these are the uses of sum function. So next one we are moving to average. What is the use of average? Using average, we can able to calculate the average value. So for example, B equal to average of B1 is to, these two is called, then B10 equal to average of B1 is to B10. So it finds the total average value of the given cells. Next one we are moving to maximum. What is the use of maximum? So it finds the maximum values equal to C1 is to C10. So I am calculating from C1 to C10. It finds the largest value in the cell range. So selected cell range, the largest value will be identified. This is the use of maximum. Next we are moving to minimum. So minimum will find the smallest value from equal to minimum of C11 is to C15. So it finds the minimum value from Next one, we are moving to. So this is the count. It found, it finds the total number of count values. Next one, we are moving to autosum. What is the use of autosum option? It is used to add the numbers. So to use this, it is also used to find the sum, average, maximum, minimum, and count. So this autosum comprises of all these functions: sum, maximum, minimum, count, and average. So how to use this function in future? Let us see. Click on the autosum drop down list in the editing group. In the editing group, we can able to see autosum drop down list. So it is in the home tab. So we can select the function library of the formulas tab. Click on the more functions. So autosum, we have to click on more functions. So if we want to calculate the sum, we have to select the cells and do the calculations, that is addition. So
Excel, PowerPoint, Word. How you can save the word dot?
everyone. Had blocks, cap blocks, stack blocks, reporter blocks, conditional blocks and looping blocks. Had blocks, cap blocks, stack blocks, reporter blocks, conditional blocks and looping blocks. Let us see one by one. First one is the had blocks. So the concept of had block means blocks will start with script. As the name says, these blocks are shaped like hat. How they are hat? The hat is? Yes, it is like a hat. So such a way that no block can be placed on the top of it. So in above the hat, we cannot place any block. So the bottom of the had block is same as that of the other block. So that can be easily stand for all the had blocks are present either in the control block. Variables will be in the above block of this student is list of students. So this is the block. So it will be represented in red color. So let us see how to use this Scratch block. So we already know how to. There are many blocks in this Scratch. Let us learn move block. All the instructions related to the movement of the script are represented in the motion block. Yes, sir. Animation should be moved or not? Yes. Only the animation is moving. We can able to see the picture or video with interest. So move block will give the instruction for the animation to move. So open the Scratch. By default, the motion block is open. When we are opening the Scratch, the motion block is open. We can select if there is an image of cat. If I want to move 10 steps or 30 steps, I can select move 10 steps or move 30 steps. Then turn block. What is the use of turn block? Turn block is used to give this little direction. If it wants to move, go straight or turn back, turn right. So this is the use of turn block. Turn 15 degrees. If I want to turn the cat 15 degrees, it will change to 15 degrees. So this is the use of turn block. Next one we are moving to. So we can also be able to change this time this turn 15 degree. Thus turn 15 degree. So we can be able to give the necessary turns. So how to make a script dance? Let us see how to make a script dance. So combination of move and turn. Combination of move and turn will make a dance. Yes or no? Yes. It is going, it is turning, running, jumping. These are the dance, script dance. So select when clicked from the event block. So you have to select when clicked. Drag and drop the move and turn block. We have to select move and turn blocks. So the flag will execute the project. By clicking on the flag, it will execute the project. Next we are moving to repeat block. What is the use of repeat block? So every time when we are clicking on the repeat block, the action gets repeated. Suppose the cat want to jump 10 times, I can give repeat 10. So the cat will jump 10 times. Next one, save blocks. So we can use also make the script say a word. So if my cat want to say hello, good morning, I can use this save block. So by clicking on the event block, what is the event block? When flag clicked is the event block. By clicking on the event block, we have to select the hello. So we have to wait for 1 second. Then for 2 seconds. So say hello, the cat will say hello and it wait 1 second and it think and says for 2 seconds. So say for hello for 2 seconds and say hello for 2 seconds. When I'm clicking the flag button, it gets executed. How it will get executed? Hello, hello, hello. This will get executed in the cat. Let us see. Hi, how are you? This is asking, hi, how are you? This is replying, what's up? I am fine, thank you. So, these are some saying block. This is the say block in Scratch. So, change the color effect by block. We can also be able to change the color effect of the block. So, we have to change the color and effect. So, it changes the different colors. So, we can be able to change the 20, 30. So, we can use negative numbers also. So, by changing the colors, the image will also get different colors. So, next we are moving to changing the backdrop of the stage. So, the new backdrop I also use to change the backdrop. So, we have to set backdrop for the stage. We can use the new backdrop option. We can either create our own backdrop or choose the backdrop from the available option. So, choose the backdrop from the library. If I want to give background as scenery, I can say if I am having it in my laptop or my computer, I can use it. Otherwise, I can set the default background. So, you can choose the backdrop from the Scratch library by clicking on this option. Backdrop library, window pops up, we can see the different type of backdrop option. Finally, we can give the necessary, for example, a scenery. I can select the scenery and click on the OK button. It will be applied as background. So, paint new backdrop. If I want to paint, I can use the background window editor and I can paint. Then upload background frame file. If I want to upload a frame, I can also be able to upload using the option select file to upload the app. So, this is the option. We can also include the new changed. When you start this command process, it begins with the cat script. So only cat will appear. The looks block menu can also be used to change the appearance of the script. So how to change it? You have to select the costumes tab to see and edit the script's costume. If you want to change the costume of the script, I am able to select the costume of the script. So how to change it? Let us see. So select the costumes tab. By clicking on the costumes tab, new costume option are displayed. So choose option, we have to select the gallery, paint new costume, upload costume from file, new costume from camera. We can include any type of picture. If I am saving it in camera, I can include it from it. If I am saving it in my desktop, I can include it from it. So we can able to change the necessary costume. So click on the choose costume from the library button. The number of choices will appear from the costume library. So select the costume from the category and we can able to, if I want to add a butterfly or a bug or a dinosaur, I can able to include from this type of costume library. So I can include different type of cat, dog, so butterfly, bat. So I can include it from the costume library. Finally, I can able to click the OK button. So we can also paint a new costume. First we have to select from the costume tab. So our script will with new costume says something. So if I want to include hello, I can include it using same block. So we can also design new costumes. So this is all about Scratch. Scratch is nothing but it is a programming language. There are 40 languages in Scratch. So it is mainly used for creating scripts. So animation, stories, animation, we can also include sound, video, voice effects, etc. in the Scratch using different options. So let us see the glossary. Move. It consists of instruction to the movement of the script. Turn, search, begin, turn, repeat. So the action will get repeated. Hand, so beginning of the script. So it is the beginning of the script. It is used to stop, cap is used to stop the execution. Reporter, it reports the value. Control, these blocks are used to control the execution of the script. Sensing, so detect different factors of the project. Variable, it is available under data block. It contains blocks related to the variables. So you have to complete the book bag activity for chapter number 6, that is MS Excel creating spreadsheets, and chapter number 7, more on Scratch. That is more about Scratch. We have learned how to create animated pictures. Then how to create the sound effect and how to start and stop the animation of the sprint, that is the scratch animation. So you have to complete the book bag activity, that is the fill in the blanks, whether true or false, then answer the following, etc. So today we have discussed about MS Excel 2010. The version is 2010, and we have learned about more about Scratch. So in Scratch we can able to see different animations. So the animation stories and animation videos are made using this Scratch. So this is a programming language. So you have to revise all these two chapters and you have to complete the book bag activity for these two